All right, hello guys. I'm back. Hopefully my throat doesn't sound too screwed up right now because I was talking quite a bit earlier. I took a quick food break and I was, because my parents have left the house, thank balls, for right now. It's 8 in the morning, so it's still the same day, but I took a minute just to grab a bite to eat so that I'm not worried about that. Oh my god, I just realized. Wow. Can't believe the whole night has passed by already. That's insane.
It's so nice to de-stress.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. Old vase. There seems to be a darkened remains of a stem inside the vase. It was probably used to hold flowers. The word for avine are at the bottom of the words, are at the bottom of the bottle. It seems to have been a gift to someone named Avine or Avin, I don't know. I'm assuming it's like Avine. Okay, cutscene, I guess.
Look, there's someone over there.
Yeah, we need to be careful.
Good idea. Let's approach him slowly without alarming him.
Now I am expecting a message at some point, so I apologize if I have to like abruptly stop what I'm doing. Hello, sir. Hello?
Wait. You're...
He can't speak, and his eyes are unfocused. But he looks too young to be anyone's grandfather. Also, why is he the only one here?
Didn't expect to see him here.
Who?
You know him?
Probably an old acquaintance.
He's Razak, a senior of mine at the academia.
He's a scholar too? Is he the kind that holes up in a forest and mumbles stuff about training?
No. And that's the problem. Razak was never involved in any of those things. He never trained in the forest, let alone reached Satyavada life. Leaving that question aside for the moment, him being here alone means that we might be too late. Looks like they've already taken everyone away. For whatever reason, they left Razak here. Perhaps they simply didn't have time to come back for him.
Smudge.
There are drag marks on the ground. They're clearer by the doorway. Someone was forcefully drawing a cart that was loaded with something heavy.
Loaded with people?
Dead people?
That is one possibility. It looks like they were in a hurry, as if they were afraid of being caught. In their haste, they failed to notice Razak hiding in a corner. The symptoms are identical. Looks like we found living proof.
Huh? Why do you say that?
Allow me to jog your memory. Recall your time at Port Ormos.
Yep, great music.
Don't
Gorgeous
you think
location.
His symptoms look familiar?
They look familiar to the person that was subjected to the information thing, the red one. Yeah. Where he had like lost his brain capabilities. The Eremite guy who went mad.
Oh, now that you mention it, they're acting the same way.
They're
correct. The academia is behind all of this. It isn't difficult to deduce their rationale. First, the academia spread a false rumor of the Scarlet King's resurrection, emphasizing the role of the village keepers, the mad scholars who were exiled to Aru Village. These rumors were all the persuasion that the radicals needed, and those based in Aru Village leapt into action. Unbeknownst to them, of course, through rounding up the scholars, they were actually helping the academia. As well as being able to exploit the radicals for their own ends, this scheme has one further advantage to the academia. All the risks and responsibilities are offloaded onto the Scarlet King's followers. Life for the desert dwellers has been brutal ever since the Scarlet King's death all those years ago. Beneath the surface, feelings of desperation are widespread. Many would give everything they have for the prospect of something better. Anyone looking to exploit that for their own ends simply needs to make a few empty promises. Even if complications arise, people will see that those involved are all followers of the Scarlet King and look for no further explanation than differences of belief. A deep-seated mistrust of the desert and everyone in it by the rest of Sumeru will make sure of that. The notion of an academia plot wouldn't even cross their minds. It may seem like a simple strategy, but it is able to work wonders under Sumeru's current circumstances.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. It's in line with the village chief's theory, too. But there's still one very important question. Wasn't it the academia that brought the scholars to Aru Village in the first place? Why does it want them back now?
Throughout this process, one thing has changed. The scholars' identity. First, they were scholars. Then, they became lunatics. After that, they were exiles. And finally, they become missing persons. An exile is still patently a living, breathing human being. But when someone becomes a missing person, that is brought into question. If you can't find someone, you have no way of knowing what exactly happened to them. That makes missing people an ideal resource.
Resource? For what exactly?
One possibility is that the information in their brains could be extracted into knowledge capsules.
Extracted? You mean canned knowledge comes from people's brains?
With the technology of the Sumeru Academia, it's entirely possible. Perhaps the process caused them great suffering, which is why they cry out in the dead of night, when no one is watching them.
So, the human brain... Nope! Nah! Paimon doesn't want to think about this!
I'm the Academia scribe, after all. I'm familiar with their projects. Anyway, judging by Razak's state, the contents of a divine knowledge capsule were extracted from his mind. But something went wrong in the process. Or perhaps his curiosity got the better of him, and he used such a capsule for himself.
Paimon's a little confused. Can they just use anyone's brain?
The look on your face tells me you've realized the answer.
The academia needs people who have been exposed to the divine consciousness.
That's right. To some scholars, gaining knowledge about the gods is their entire life's pursuit. Extracting canned knowledge is just one of the extreme measures they turn to. However, I can't help but wonder, what do they seek to gain from divine knowledge? The academia is going out of their way to look for forbidden knowledge, but what is their ultimate goal? I've spent quite some time trying to analyze the contents of the divine knowledge capsule, but to no avail. It seems like my way of thinking is too different from theirs.
You mean you're not even slightly interested in getting your hands on this forbidden stuff?
All scholars seek to expand the horizons of knowledge, but I'm not particularly interested in gods. So I don't share their degree of zealotry. Extracting information from people as if they were lifeless objects? If this is the direction of academic progress, then the academia may as well shut its doors.
Sounds like you're really against all this.
Well, I mean, I don't blame him.
The academia's actions run contrary to their rules. Whether it be academics or knowledge, everything has its boundaries. If those lines are crossed, the rules and order that govern everything in the world will be destroyed. This matter needs to be corrected, just like fixing a typo in a book.
Wait!
How do you fix it?
Didn't you step in to help because you felt sympathy for those poor people?
How do you fix a typo in a
callous,
book?
But no. My criteria are a little more restrictive than that. There is no shortage of suffering in Sumeru, and the same can be said for the rest of Teyvat as well. What do you plan to do about that? Save every last person?
Probably not. Paimon's not sure.
You can say that. Simply put, I don't blindly place my faith into strength or heroism. I do what I want. The Divine Knowledge Capsule is something I want to investigate in full. That doesn't mean I'm willing to take action for the sake of a few strangers.
Thank you.
going to say this for a while. There are a lot of bad guys in the academia, but you're not one of them. You're their weirdo.
You're probably right. Though I must say, I quite enjoy this feeling of being the odd one out. Uniqueness is also an asset, is it not?
Wow, that's a great way to think about it. Paimon's really impressed. If only Miss Shani had a similar mindset, her life would definitely be a lot easier.
I'm just a more likable person than her in general. There's nothing more to it than that. He won't last long if we leave him here. Let's take him with us. We'll work out our next step after we return to Aru Village.
What the fuck? Damn it, I missed him. Whoa, we are on the edge of the map here. What is going on? Oh, I see. That's weird that they didn't, like, make this playable, the coastline. Okay, well, fine. But let me see what else is in here. Like, what's this? Is this the key? It is the key, ancient key, okay. Alright, just a moment for a second here, guys. Okay. Alright, we didn't get to search anything past this point, I don't think. Dusty tableware. Hakim. Oh, what the hell? That's so stupid, man. Stop it. Aveen. Yeah, what kind of treasure we're gonna find in a bedside cabinet. The shelves are full of thin books. You browse through them and find that they seem to be hospital documents such as medical records and financial statements. You shut the door in disappointment. Alright, Paimon has a point. I like how she says at least those had cabbage or fowl inside. That's funny when you break open like the crates and stuff. Oh, jeez. Patient name, Abbas. Gender, male. Occupation, farmer. Basic status at admission. Scabby skin at limb extremities. Multiple ulcers on the back, chest, and other bodily surfaces. Weakness of limbs and poor mobility observed. Mental faculties are coherent, though there are clear signs of fatigue, poor sleep quality, and poor appetite. Doctor in charge, Amudi. Week 1 of hospitalization, new scabs at limb extremities and enlarged ulcers. The left arm seems unusable and is in pain. Mental faculties are coherent, though there are clear signs of fatigue, poor sleep quality, and poor appetite. Week 3, the scabs are scale-like and have spread across the surface of the body. There is necrosis in multiple ulcers. The patient has fallen into a coma. Week 9, the necrosis of the ulcers has been effectively kept under control, and no new scabs have appeared on the surface of the body. The patient is in a comatose state. Suddenly, the doctor in charge is blocked out, and we can see that there is some sort of effective reversement of the disease happening, which we know is probably Fatui at work here now. Week 15. The wound from the replacement treatment has not healed, even after a long time. No new scabs have appeared on the surface of the body. There is weakness in the limbs, and the patient cannot grasp items on their own. The patient is also experiencing fever and vomiting. Mental faculties are coherent, though fatigued, poor sleep, and unable to eat. We have started to manage to keep, or the week 21, we have started to manage to keep the scabs on the body surface under control, and new limbs functions has been restored. The patient is experiencing chronic coughing and is prone to fainting. Mental faculties are coherent and in a good state. Sleep quality and appetite are decent. Huh. Yeah, it is, actually, but... Treatment subject. Abbess, male, farmer, doctor in charge, blocked out. Status. After 20 weeks of treatment, specimen 4's new skin and new left arm have recovered well. No changes in appetite or sleep. Mental state fluctuations beyond the normal range. There have been multiple attempts to leave the care area. God's voice guides me is cited as motivation, and the specimen is believed to have delusional tendencies. Additionally, the God's voice described in the confession is possibly related to the resonant quake phenomenon present in the internal topographic structure of the dunes. This should be investigated to rule out ungovernable input interference. Increase supervision. Treatment protocol. The second phase of blank trial is beginning to see results. The next phase, blank, objective, specimen 4's organs, blank, following extensive examination, sample 3 is the best material for the third phase of the blank trial. Before the implementation of blank, blank is required. Continuous vomiting and skin, blank, is a normal occurrence. Blank must be prepared beforehand for specimen 4 to maintain the circulation of blank. After completion of the basic blank operation, observe the subject for 1 week. If normal activity is observed in the organs, the rate of deterioration of surface scabs is reduced, and limb function is restored. The next phase of the blank trial can commence. Physicians note, all specimens have one thing in common. Body elemental quantities were at abnormally high levels, and were positively correlated with the severity of the disease. After the blank experiment, body elemental quantities were reduced, and samples self-reported a reduction in symptoms. It is reasonable to hypothesize that there is a causal relationship between elemental quantities and Eleazar. More controlled trials should be conducted to exclude redundant variables. Note, the enrichment process of elemental quantities in humans may be dynamically sustained. After the completion of early blank experiments within a short period of time, specimen 1's physical indicators trended to the norm. In later stages, due to blank not being complete, the quantity of elements in the sample bodies were bounded, and symptoms increased, leading to specimen 1 blank. I'm assuming like dying or something. Could not be recycled for materials. That's great. Information contained. Preparations must be made for long-term trials. Blank cannot be stopped before the specimen's symptoms have stabilized. Due to the nature of the trial, there must be a method to stabilize the sample's moods. Removal of blank may be tempted. What, the frontal lobe? Following the new method, the material rejection rate has been significantly reduced. Specimens 2 and 3 developed mental instability due to associative connections to fundamental inner qualities of blank, and tended to attribute the disease to unverifiable divine punishment. Consequently, considering it blasphemy to accept blank as treatment, it is a very interesting thought. Exploring neurostimulation and the resulting cognitive shifts should be a future research topic, or could be. Due to the above uncontrollable variables, they halted at stage 2. A shame. However, the materials provided by these two samples were the best quality materials so far. It is reasonable to believe that the perfect performance of specimen 4 is related to the material quality provided by these two samples. Ultimately, once the 3-stage experiment was completed, specimen 4's symptoms disappeared completely, proving that it is possible to use blank to control the elemental content of a person's body without relying on elemental power. There is a potential for weaponization. Discussions of research on blank have to be increased for the future. Humans have unlimited potential. It may be foolish for me as a researcher to write this, but with good input, I might be able to reach the level of a god, or so people might call it. So this is probably... I don't think this is Balladeer. I think this is probably the doctor, since he was with the academia and then was cast out, right? So this might be why he was cast out, because of this shit he's doing. And then he, I don't know if he was always a harbinger or if he became a harbinger, worked with the Fatui and whittled his way back into the academia, who he's now basically pulling all the strings to do all this random shit behind the scenes. Yeah, ignorance might be bliss. got an achievement before my time. People don't want to mention his name, nor do want to remember his words or deeds. Well, I don't know. I guess we don't know who it is. We might know who it is. I just... I'm too dumb to know too much. Okay, so I think we gathered everything that was here in this little back area. Suppose we can actually just fast travel. Sorry, my brain's kind of wandering a little bit there for a minute. Knock, knock.
We're back!
Oh, Otto.
You must be tired. You should rest and take some water.
What's the situation?
Hmm? Who's this?
Unfortunately, somebody who's too young to take on the role of Isak's grandfather. Nevertheless, he's one of the people we're trying to find.
So, at one point in time, the abandoned Elazar Hospital served as the Academia's site for extracting divine cant knowledge.
Yep, pretty much.
Their plan must have been implemented at some point before we arrived at Aru Village, since divine cant knowledge has been in circulation for a while now. Yet, they fled once we were headed to the village, almost as if they knew we were on their trail. Why is that?
Because there's probably someone working on the inside here.
Why is that?
We may have a mole in our midst.
Uh-huh.
One of us could be secretly revealing our whereabouts to the Academia.
Who?
Huh? Are our friendships that shallow?
Looks like none of you have realized wherein lies the issue. Sino, you're the reason why they can predict our movements.
What?
Wait, what's that supposed to mean?
Choose your next words very carefully.
It is simply a logical inference. I have my reasons.
So what you're saying is... Sino's the mole.
But why?
Interesting. And here I thought you were the most suspicious one, Alhatham. Since you were always acting alone.
I know. You have a point. But I realized something as we were returning from the hospital. Sino isn't like any of us.
What are you trying to say?
Do you still remember who you are, General Mahamatra? As a Matra, you are no doubt privy to certain kinds of information. Before you can take action against someone, you are required to have all the facts available, including the less than savory details. Simply put, the Academia has traditionally allowed you access to a wealth of sensitive information. Knowing their modus operandi, wouldn't you expect them to take precautions against you?
Modus operandi.
If you want to raise a vicious wolf, you need to make sure that you can avoid its bite.
The Academia is monitoring me?
Well, that makes total sense.
It's not that simple. The Academia has eyes all over Sumeru, but they have a special protocol for dealing with you. Every so often comes a Nyagarbaha day.
Mm-hmm.
On this day, the Academia enters new information into the Akasha through knowledge capsules. I remember seeing a thick notebook next to the control panel once. Its contents were all about the General Mahamatra, his activities throughout the day, preferred methods of enacting judgment, everything.
You're saying that the Academia entered my information into the Akasha too? But what's the point in doing that? My actions aren't important enough to be added into the Akasha.
The Akasha is capable of computation.
I don't know what the fuck that means. I don't know what that word means.
The Akasha's algorithms are entirely capable of predicting your movements using the data entered. When you would depart, the route you would follow, your destination. It knew all of this.
Wow, what the hell?
It predicted my every move.
The Academia has been watching you longer than you think.
So that's how it is. Sino adheres to his principles so strongly that he's actually a thorn in their side. Tenacity of will and steadfast faith are worthless to the Academia. They need scholars who are easily pliable and mindlessly go after anything they can profit from. Sino, don't take it to heart. This just proves how much of a trustworthy ally you are.
They escaped because of me.
Don't blame yourself. It's not like any of us would have known.
I have an idea. If they predicted my movements, then I might be able to guess where they went.
Whoa, you bounced back fast.
There is always an opportunity for safety after danger passes.
Oh, so that's how it is! Paimon gets it now! If the Academia is trying to avoid Sino, then the safest place would be... Yep, that's right!
They'll want to proceed in the direction opposite of where I'm going.
Apparently Paimon's getting smarter.
I must go.
There's also something I want to investigate.
Let's go, guys! After him!
Please, wait! I want to go too!
You want to go too? If so, you have to promise you'll stay safe.
I don't think it's that simple.
I want to find Grandpa. I promise I'll be careful and not cause any trouble.
Maybe he's...
I leave him in your hands.
Yay! Let's go! Remember to pack some food with you! Paimon feels like we're missing someone, though.
Where's Dia? Is that who we're missing?
I'll be awaiting your good news.
Please, stay safe, everyone.
Okay. So it looks like we're heading off into the desert, finally. Like, properly.
Next on the agenda.
Next on the agenda. There's a giant pyramid with a giant suction butt on it.
Yes. After leaving the village, we should head straight toward the desert.
Well, define desert here.
I know the desert like the back of my hand.
Is that because you play here a lot?
Yep. One time, Grandpa almost got lost in the desert, but I was the one who brought him back.
Good Lord, man, look at that. What the fuck is that thing, though?
There's something here. What's this?
Sand?
Yeah, it's buried in
sand. Of course, rough and irritating.
Looks like we'll need to roll up our sleeves and do some work.
You fly!
Okay. So, we have to dig it out? Whatever's down there looks like it's buried really deep.
Hmm.
These are likely fragments of an academia-developed device, something akin to a headset. Looks like there were more than one village keeper. They must have been escorted this way, because there are device fragments scattered around here. Let's split up and search the area. Chances are that we'll find other things nearby.
That's just a fragment of a headset? Everyone goes in different directions and starts digging in sand. After a short while, you dig up another device nearby.
Is this what we're searching for? It looks kind of scary.
Looks kind of badass.
This is definitely a device used to extract divine knowledge.
Okay, I don't want to wear
it. How did it end up buried in the sand? That can't have been part of the plan. They must have been attacked along the way.
Wait, what?
Grandpa, I hope you're okay.
Well, there's no dead bodies, little kid, so at the very least, he might still be alive.
Razak didn't display any signs of starvation or dehydration, which means that they left fairly recently.
We should be able to catch up.
One more thing. Given that the device had been entirely covered by sand, I believe the attack must have happened prior to the sandstorm.
Oh, so they like literally left a night or two ago.
Let's keep going. They can't have gone far.
But running on sand is so tiring!
Paimon!
But you're flying, aren't you, Paimon? Is flying over sand tiring too?
Of course it is!
Oh my god, there's a tumbleweed! Fuck, it's gone. There's a fast travel point way up there, apparently.
Voices, over there. It sounds like an argument.
Bitch, I don't hear anything.
Whoa, you have really good ears.
Yeah, you do.
Don't get any closer. They'll notice us.
Diaz talking with the Aramites? Very interesting. Let's listen in.
If you had informed me sooner, there'd be plenty of room for us to...
You're one of us. We would never lie.
Scholars. You don't know as much as I do. Need me to...
I knew it. That's our Dia.
Dia? Why would you...
Dia!
Oh no! What the hell, kid?
Hey! What are you doing?
Huh?
Didn't you say you'd help me find Grandpa? Why are you on their side?
Well, look who's here. Ain't that something?
This complicates things.
You've betrayed Aru Village.
We don't have enough information yet, prick.
So... this is the great General Mahamantra.
Is that a tornado in the background?
Yeah, you'd be better off as my assistant than hanging around with this motley crew. Seen for yourself, I have the means and methods, and my ideals are far more admirable than theirs.
I'm not the type that's easily swayed, Rahman. You of all people should know that.
Wait, what's going on, Dia? Whose side are you on here?
Shut it, Paimon.
Holy shit!
It doesn't matter. Whichever side you pick, nothing could deter us from the grand mission of resurrecting the Scarlet King. Once our Lord of Old returns to this land, we will have a new beginning.
Face the facts, Rahman. It's not gonna happen. You should understand that more than anyone. Have all your years as a merc taught you nothing about placing hopes in a ruler?
I'm a desert dweller and a proud follower of the Scarlet King. Whether I live by the edge of the sword or in peaceful comfort, my soul will always carry this conviction.
It's not too late yet. The village keep... mad scholars aren't gonna bring the Scarlet King back to life.
You don't understand, my dear lady. Pursuing our faith is our purpose in life. Even if the chance of success is one in a million, we must be willing to give everything we have.
Even if it'll expose you to the academia? Even if they end up disbanding the Aramites? Your Aramites, which you've worked so hard for all these years?
Yes. We've waited a long time for this day to come. The sun and the moon no longer shine here. All you see now is cracks in this desiccated land. But fate has finally dealt me a hand to play against the Academia. With these scholars in our custody, we'll stomp the Academia's forces and fight our way beyond the wall of Samael.
Ridiculous. Think about it. The Academia controls the entirety of Sumeru. Your powers are negligible in comparison. If you still don't believe me, then try asking these two men. They're also against the Academia, but neither of them are as arrogant as you are.
They look more like pawns of the Academia to me. Why would I listen to anything the people of Greater Lord Rukadavada have to say? Filthy traitors. Your god abandoned all honor and betrayed the Scarlet King. We desert dwellers will never trust the likes of you.
It's impossible to communicate with someone so hostile. Perhaps we should.
Do you really believe that by kidnapping the scholars, you'll be able to negotiate with the Academia? These people have no value as bargaining chips, but I could be persuaded to take their place as your next hostage. These scholars were exiled from the Academia. I, on the other hand, am their current scribe, and will be a much greater asset to you.
Wait, you can't be serious.
So, you want to trade places with the hostages, do you?
Precisely. Any wise person would gladly accept my offer. Well, that would be bad luck for me. However, I'd get the chance to observe the scholars, perhaps even find out the truth.
Think you can talk me over with that confident look of yours?
I'm not trying to persuade you. I'm using this as a means of joining forces against the Academia.
You are the scribe. What do you have against the Academia?
Not all desert dwellers believe in the Scarlet King, and the same applies to the Academia. Why must all knowledge seekers approve of the Academia's way of doing things?
You Academia scum! Every last one of you is nothing but a hypocrite, just like everyone else on the other side of that wall. I've made myself clear enough. I won't listen to another word from the Dendro Archon's people.
It's like Aki's mother.
Not so fast.
Total prick.
I'll hate them. Do you stand by everything you just said?
I never make empty promises.
You know you're making a dangerous decision, right?
I do.
Good. Raman, hear me out. These people are my friends. Maybe you can't take the followers of the Dendro Archon at their word, but what about me? Do you trust me?
We've known each other for years. Of course I do.
In that case, I'm willing to vouch for their honesty with my right arm.
Whoa. Don't cut her arm off.
Come on, Raman, don't be a coward. If you're serious about taking on the Academia, you need to steel yourself. You can't be afraid.
An arm from the Flame Mane. You've piqued my interest. But what if you refuse to oblige? What should I do then? No one's a fool here, dear. We're mercs. And mercs don't tend to live long unless they have their wits about them.
You're not wrong, but this is different. I promised my friends that we'd bring back the village keepers together.
Let's do it right here then. Give me your right arm as proof of your resolve.
Don't listen to him! He's not even trying to negotiate! He just wants to make things more difficult!
That's fine.
Are you crazy?
We came here to save lives. One arm for that many people is still a pretty good deal, if you ask me. Raman, I'm holding up my end of the deal here. You'd better not let me down.
Sure. Go ahead and cut off her right arm.
What the fuck? I'm not gonna do that. This game doesn't have the balls to do that.
No! Dia! What are you gonna do? Think of something!
I want to know what's going on in the background. That's way the fuck more interesting.
This far.
That's not for you to decide.
Do it. Stop!
Oh my god, come on. That man's swing was super fast.
Can't do it.
Flame Mane, you and I are both desert folk. Cutting off your arm is no different than cutting off my own fingers. Where's the sense in cutting my own kin to pieces? You've shown me that you're serious. Go on now, take your friends and leave. Meet me in the desert at noon tomorrow.
Where? The desert's like huge. That's like me saying, meet me in the United States of America tomorrow at noon. Where?
I was really counting on him not going through with it.
Dia! That was crazy! Have you all lost your minds? What if he'd actually cut your arm off?
Then I'd just have to hold my claymore with my left arm. Okay, I'm sorry. But sometimes when you're out on a limb, you gotta double down to seal the deal, you know?
Don't ever make a promise like that again. I can deal with the likes of them. If it came down to it, you would not lose to them either.
I don't doubt it, Sino. But this is about more than me and them. There's a lot more where they came from. Even if we got rid of one bunch of radicals, there are others out there. Wiping them out would do more harm than good.
As you wish.
I'm sorry, Dia. I should have stayed put and listened. I should have trusted you.
Well, you're just a kid.
It's okay. I promised you I'd help find your grandpa, so I'll do whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes? You just might be scholar material.
Huh? Are you serious?
The Eremites once said that I was a lunatic. Perhaps a little madness is essential to be successful in research.
Why does it feel like he's using his praise for me as an excuse to brag about himself?
I love the way she said that.
Okay, let's get moving. We should head back to the village and rest up. Today was just a trial run. Noon tomorrow is gonna be the hard part.
Wow, what an interesting thing to say there at the end. That kind of makes me wonder what's gonna happen next. Secret of the Scorching Desert. Wait until the following morning, 6 to 8. What is this? Oh, it must be up there. Because it says there's an oculi right here, or an oculus, but how do I get up there? Because, like, it's got the lip on it. It looks like... Okay, that must be the one over there that I was... I guess if we could get up there, it might... You know what, I'm going to do that quick. Well, we're up to 44 minutes here. Before we go in and continue with the story, I'm actually going to try to get up here so that I can get that fast travel point so that I don't have to climb this thing anymore.
We're way behind schedule.
This looks climbable here. What's with the creep? What's all the creep music? Dude, I love the colors here. Not just the desert itself, but the sky. It's got this gorgeous purpley blue to it, and when the sun was going down, it was pink. Good God, this almost reminds me of Satisfactory, because I always started in the rocky desert. I gotta play that game again. I still get active comments on it, in that series, for whatever reason. I'm not exploring as much as I'm just trying to get a more... Yeah, see, there's a chest up here and stuff. I'm just trying to get this fast travel point so that I can get up here easily whenever I do go to explore. Well, since we're here, these scorpions seem to be interested in the electro thing. Okay, that thing over there. That's what I wanted to look at. Because it looked like a tornado. But it doesn't seem to be moving. But it's very clearly... It's very clearly a big swirling storm on what looks to be a whole bunch of rocks or sand that has formed the same way. That might be in the... Is that unplayable? No, it is not. Either... That's just off the map, or that's this down here. But I'm going to assume that's off the map, because I am almost positive that we're going to get more desert here. Because this just feels weird, the way that the map is laid out, you know? How you have this, and then there's pathways literally leading here. I mean, look, there's a fast travel point on the border. There's a fast travel point right here on the border. There's probably even more. There's a fast travel point on the border. Right next to other fast travel points, and then it just cuts right off like this, you know, and then has this weird shape. So I'm assuming there's going to be more desert later. I could probably glide down to that. Do we want to do that? Do we want to open up? Where's the other one? There's one down there, and then the other one's somewhere else down that way. I love the sand that's pouring off the side of these. Okay, tell you what, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to... Oh, this is so incredible looking. I'm gonna glide to that other statue, or at least get close. We're going to pop the statue, and then I'll fast travel back. Hell, I might even just head south and get that statue too. Or I guess we don't need to fast travel, we need to wait. But that's probably just going to happen by... means of time here, and then I'll cut this episode off. That way we can open up the rest of the map down here and then just be okay with it. I mean, that looks incredible over there, though. Oh, nope, see, down there, just above my head, those are the sunken ruins right here. Or I guess it's called Eye of the Sands. I thought it was sunken ruins. What am I thinking of? I'm thinking of Final Fantasy, probably. And if I think we're seeing these structures right here, right there. So that is off map. But that's incredible looking. At first, I thought it was like a dynamic tornado, like a dust devil way off in the distance. That would have been awesome if they could model something like that. That just kind of moves around the map a little bit. I'm curious to know what that actually is, though. I mean, it's twisted the terrain to the point where it looks like it's been there for a while, so it's got to be something important. And it looks like, right now, this desert goes on for ages. I mean, look at that. Not only... is there dunes beyond the map border? There's dunes beyond the dunes. It looks like I might almost be able to make it. I'm gonna go this way, just in case. This is incredible, finally getting to have a desert. I'm so happy about that. So satisfied. And these things help you get around so much. The little thing, the like things you can tether to. I'm also really happy with the addition of those. Oh. I got an achievement! Dropped a bird egg. I wanted to see if I could break those, and it turns out I can. Break a tumbleweed drifting in the desert. Hey, I'll take an extra achievement just because. Oh. Now that I know they drop stuff, I'm gonna be yoinking those.
We're way behind schedule.
I wonder if you can see that storm. I don't think you can see that storm from... Oh, what the fuck is that thing up there in the sky? I don't know. Wait a minute, that's that thing! Hold on. Yeah. That's that thing up in the sky that we saw way back in the day. It's always been in the sky, but it's modeled. It used to be what looked like a 2D image on the skybox, right? If I'm just speaking from a gameplay point of, or from a technical point of view, that's what it looked like, but it looks like it's modeled now. So it's somewhere, I'm assuming, because when you're in Mondstadt, it's kind of off this direction. So I'm assuming it's somewhere in and around here. I have no idea what that is. I think I have a little bit of memory of way back in like the beginning of my LP, someone had actually posted a comment about what that place is, and I don't remember what. I just remember getting a comment about that. Well, we're near the giant pyramid thing. Alright, let's activate the statue. Happy nobody's broken these statues. That is awesome. That's how you know it's a desert. You see all this detail and what do they call it? Topography? I don't know. What's topography? Huh? Whatever. Anyways, you can see the terrain on the map, and then you just got flat in the desert over here with giant. It looks like there's four mini pyramids. Oh no, it looks like there's three surrounding it. Okay, so I want to head south, and I can actually see it. Warship. Let me see. What is this? Primogems and key and sigils. Apparently, I need 20. Holy crap. I won't worry about that right now. I can see the other one way over there, so I'm going to try my best to get over there. Looks like I might be able to head up this direction. God, I am so happy to be alive while this game is a thing. What the hell? I'm curious if these guys have their own kill stats, because they're not enemies, they're like animals or whatever, they're not monsters. I guess I can check. Let's see, if I go to archive. Living beings. Let me see here. I thought there was a place where you could see. Yeah, there's that dinosaur thing, and then the flying version. Apparently, it's a lot of automatons that we haven't found yet. Here we go. Here's the new other human factions. They got an Eremite axe girl, the like auto repeater crossbow guy, polearm user. This guy with whatever the fuck those things are. Bendy sword guy. The dancer girl, which I think is cute. The big heavy guy. And then the guy that has that attack that hits you from 2 miles away if you're not ready for it. Mythical beasts. We've got the Electra, which is fine now. Various different types of these shroom creatures. These are the different top variants. I like that they have different designs, by the way. Like, this is very clearly the same enemy, just with, you know, Cryo, Electro, Pyro. But look at how the head is different, depending on... The body's the same, but the head changes depending on what it is. Which I like that. It's got a brownie here. What the hell this thing is. Grounded Hydro Shroom. I always called it a bird. Winged Cryo Shroom. Grounded Geo Shroom. The boss... Okay, I don't see... Oh, right here. That's what I'm supposed to be clicking on, is this. Oh, it doesn't show you how many kills you've gotten with them. Damn it. Oh, well. Apparently we found Snowfinch. Violet Ibis. Duskbird. Yeah, Red Vulture. The Snow Fox. The Desert Fox. The Kitsune. Oh, wait, but there's a net next to it. That must be that thing where you can capture them. So it looks like some you can capture, so I guess I can't capture like mallard ducks or emerald ducks. But anything that has a net next to it, there's actually stats for capturing them. The Great Snowboar King. Shroomboar. Redtail Weasel. Boot Weasel. Masked Weasel. Blue Thunder Weasel. I don't remember ever finding that. The Golden Weasel Thief. The Bake Danuki. Spinal Crocodile, Rishbull and Tiger, the Scorpion, the Shaggy Sumpter Beast. We found a new fish, the Floating Ray, the Moonfin, and then the Lazurite Axe Marlin and the Halcyon, whatever that is. So apparently there's not a lot of fish that I haven't actually found yet. I know a good chunk of them are in Sumeru, though. The different plants, really? Or not plants, excuse me. The different, like, little creatures that you pick up things from? That's awesome. Sunny Loach. Forest Tree Frog. There's a lot of variants of stuff. General Crab. Pale Red Crab. Marrow Lizard. Red Tail Lizard. Adorned Unagi. Deep Sea Unagi. Red Fin Unagi. Quicksand Unagi. And a Scarab. With the poop. Or whatever that is. Okay, I just wanted to see. I was actually only looking because I wanted to see if you could, if it tracked kill stats of the animals, but it doesn't. Oh well. But it's good to know that apparently you can capture this. I don't know what the point of that is, though, capturing animals. I guess I'll have to look at that. That was the Omni Ubiquity Net, I think it was called, or whatever, quest. I'm guessing this is something. Wait, can I dig this? What the hell? Oh, prick. God, there's so much for us to do in this game, man. I mean, we'll catch up on the Sumeru quest line, and that's nothing. We still got, excuse me, we've still got so much to do. So much that we can do. Somehow I missed and he didn't care at all.
I'll be back.
How are we doing on... Okay, we actually did fully regenerate our resin. I'll have to look at that then soon. Do my dailies and stuff. But we'll catch up on the Sumeru story first so that I can... probably get the new, maybe later today. I don't know when it's gonna be. We'll have to see what's happening with someone, but I'll probably do all that, and then hopefully I can get a nice intro put together, and maybe even a new outro. We'll see. I've been thinking about the outro thing, but I like the outro I've got because it's the main theme, which is just very Genshin. But I thought, you know, I could make it Sumeru themed. But I'm doing this currently just purely to try to get all of the areas on the map opened up. Oh my god, is that like a sandstone sealy court? That's neat. Got a Fatui camp up here. I'm gonna try to ignore them. They're not gonna ignore me. What the fuck? They lost interest in me and then suddenly started fighting again. That was weird. Oh, we're almost there. Okay, that chest is not just sitting out for me to grab. That something's gonna spawn from that. Again, though, they give it a varied terrain here. I mean, there's these big, like, rocky cavern areas. Whatever you call these, almost like mesas. And then there's the flat open desert that we just ran across before. Oh god, it looks like there's another big robot there. All cracked and crushed up. Yeah, this is definitely very small for such a huge desert. I want this stuff to open up. You know, I want there to be, like this right here. Can't you just add that? I mean, they added this area. to connect it. It would feel more natural, I think. But I'm wondering if they only did that just so that you can't take a boat across over to there. But then what's stopping you from taking a boat from Inazuma all the way over here? I feel like someone told me you can do that. Either way, though, the map has gotten very big, at least as far as the diagonal design is concerned. But I'm very happy. The more the map grows like this, the more epic long distances we can look at it from. Got an achievement. Dune Dream, I think. Sumeru, The Gilded Desert, Series 1. Continental Explorer, Dune Dreams 1. Light up the maps of the following areas in Sumeru. So it's just basically acquire all of those until there's new ones added. Okay, I will... I don't exactly want to fast travel back and get stuck in a cutscene. Okay, I will be right back. I'm going to take a peek break, and this video is up to an hour anyway, so I will see you in the next episode of Let's Play Genshin Impact.